Good morning, my dear students. Today I am going to teach you about eubacteria. Eu means true bacteria. Already we have learned about archaebacteria in previous class. The groups of archaebacteria. How many groups of archaebacteria are there? Three groups. What are they? Halophils, thermoisophils, metamorphs. Okay. What about eubacteria? Eubacteria consist of a rigid cell wall. So rigid cell wall is present in a eubacteria. Cyanobacteria are referred as blue green algae because they are appeared blue and green in color. Look at here, this is a diagrammatic representation of NASTAC. It's a filamentous alga, a small thread-like structure. When we are seeing this filamentous alga under the compound microscope, it appears like this. So NASTAC is one of the examples for cyanobacteria, NASTAC, and another example, Anadina. So cyanobacteria are commonly known as blue-green algae because they are appeared blue and green in color. BGA means B represent, first B stands for blue, G stands for green, A stands for algae, BGA means blue-green algae. So this is important for the objective point of view, recording case aid or in neat examination. From this concept, they may ask statement type of the question. Statement 1. Cyanobacteria are referred as blue-green algae. Okay, statement type is statement 1. Statement 2. Cyanobacteria are appears blue and green in color. Whatever the first statement, cyanobacteria are referred as a blue green algae. Is it correct or not? That is correct statement. Whatever statement to cyanobacteria are appeared blue and green in color. Statement 2 is also correct. Both the statements are correct. Okay, na? And these cyanobacteria, some are unicellular. Unicellular means they are made of single cells. And some of the cyanobacteria are colonial colonies. The several organisms are aggregated to form a colony group. So, unicellular, colonial, some are colonial forms of colonies. For example, NASTAC. Several NASTAC filaments, individual organisms are aggregated to form a colony. Filamentous in the sense they are appears like a thread. Thread like a appearance. Okay, na? So what are the examples for blue-green algae? NASTAC and Anabina. So these blue-green algae consist of chlorophyll A photosynthetic pigment and chlorophyll A is appeared green in color. Whereas phycocyanina pigments are appeared blue in color. See here, blue color dots are present the phycocyanin pigment. Green color is caused by the chlorophyll A pigments. So due to presence of equal amount of chlorophyll A and phycocyanin photosynthetic pigments, these organisms are appeared blue and green in color. Okay, so these blue-green algae are consist of specialized large size of cells. These cells are known as heterocyst. So what is the function of heterocyst? Heterocyst cells are involved in nitrogen fixation. That's important for objective point of view. in NEET examination or in KSET examination from this concept, they may ask which of the cells are involved in a nitrogen fixation in blue-green algae. Which cells are involved in nitrogen fixation? Heterocyst cells. Okay, now here in the filaments, the non-stalk filaments covered by the mucilaginous layer or mucilaginous sheath. So this is outermost layer, white layer is represent the mucilaginous sheath. This is the outermost layer. Is it clear? Okay. Next we have to know about the mode of nutrition. Mode of nutrition in cyanobacteria. The blue-green algae are involved in chemosynthetic mode of nutrition. Cyanobacteria are the chemosynthetic autotrophs. So they are oxidize the inorganic substances to get energy. Cyanobacteria are oxidize inorganic substances like as nitrates, nitrites and ammonia to get the energy. So cyanobacteria are involved in chemosynthetic mode of autotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, na? Chemosynthetic autotrophs means they are gets the energy from oxidation of inorganic substances. Autotrophs, in previous class we have learnt about the autotrophs, photosynthetic autotrophs, another one is chemosynthetic autotrophs. Here the blue-green algae are involved in chemosynthetic autotrophic mode of nutrition. Photosynthetic, okay, photosynthetic, some are photosynthetic autotrophic mode of nutrition and some are involved in chemosynthetic autotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, na? Is it clear? So next class we will discuss about the economic importance of the eubacteria. Is it clear?